Hello, today we will discuss Gulliver's travels and how the establishment of Royal Society of London and the consequent experiments carried by the scientist became the cause of satire by Jonathan Swift. Period of Jonathan Swift was a period of satire, and mostly all political and social events became the cause of satire. What needs to be noted before we start discussing the third voyage of Gulliver is that at the time of conceiving of an idea and initiation, all experiments of science seem improbable and far-fetched. If someone would have told Graham Bell about smartphones, even he would have laughed. Role of a scientist is not to endorse or reject any idea without empirical evidence. As Aristotle had defended literature, that literature deals with ideal truth. Likewise, science also tries to decode mystery which, when solved, would become clarity to the world. Gulliver's Travels, written by Jonathan Swift, is a satire in the guise of an adventure story, and the protagonist travels to various wonderlands and provides the author opportunity to satirize the then socio-political activities of England. In the third voyage, Gulliver is captured by Japanese pirates and a cruel Dutch. He is left alone in a canoe. He spots a floating island, Laputa. Gulliver observes that people's head on this island lean either right or left. They have one eye turned in and the other up. Their clothes have sun, moon, musical instruments and shapes on them. They constantly remain engrossed in their thoughts. They keep servants with flappers all the time, and flappers stuff their mouth and ears when they are required to give inputs or hear important things. Flappers also touch their eyes when they walk so as to make them see. The king of the island is busy all the time with mathematical instruments. He is engrossed in his calculations so much that he notices Gulliver after an hour during the first meeting. Gulliver's dress is measured and sewn with maths equation, and needless to say, it is very poorly made. Laputa controls the city under Balnibarbi is the capital. Laputians talk endlessly about politics. Gulliver reflects that people talk most about things that they know least. Too much preoccupation with science makes them fear the end of the world constantly. People of Balnibarbi have affairs with Laputian women, as their husbands can't notice things because of their preoccupation with science all the time. Island is controlled by a lodestone, and the king controls Balnibarbians by threatening them with blocking sun and rain or dropping the island on them. Entire account of the kingdom of Laputa is a satire on advancement of science and preoccupations with science and maths without having presence of mind or wisdom that is expected even from a common person. Gulliver wants to get down at Lagado with his friend Munodi. Gulliver is appalled with barren palms and hungry workers. Munodi explains that few years back, some people from Lagado had visited Laputa and came back with revolutionary ideas of farming, and the stupid innovation has left the entire city desolate. He then invites Gulliver to the Royal Academy of Lagado. Scientists at the Academy of Lagado are busy with ridiculous experiments like to make sunbeams out of a cucumber, to turn human poo back to its food, to melt ice into gunpowder, to build houses from the roof down, to paint without sight but according to the texture and smell of the colors, to use picks to plow the fields, to use spider webs to replace silk threads, to change the course of the moon and sun so that we can combine weather vanes and sundials. A professor in this academy has invented giant square with words in Laputian language tied with wires, and the square has handles on all the sides. Students or professors mow handles, and when three or four words come in line, they write down whatever the structure of the sentence. This way, they want to write all the books on science. Others are working on communication. One has an idea of cutting down all the words into syllables and removing verbs. The other suggests to remove speaking and carry objects that one wants to speak. Another professor writes down all maths equations on a cracker with an ink. When the student swallows the cracker, the ink dissolves into the brain and reduces the efforts to understand or memorize the things. Next, Gulliver visits political school where all academicians look crazy. One professor suggests, since politics is a body, all politicians should get periodic medical treatment to cure vices. Another one suggests how the opposition in politics can be balanced. He suggests taking out 100 people from each party and splitting their brains so that the ideas balance out. One professor suggests taking tax on bad habits and vices of citizens. The other wants to levy tax on virtues. Let us now consider why Swift attacks science. Besides innovation and production, science and technology have moral duties also. Today, we are talking about cloning or genetically modified food. Ethical science is very important. Virtual currency like Bitcoin also would lead to many ethical issues. Automation is leading to joblessness and other dependence on machines. The island of Laputa is shown as flying because many ideas of science do not look at the grassroots realities. The negative use of nuclear energy for weapons is proving disastrous. People of Laputa are busy with their abstract ideas and speculations that they don't seem to have attention to normal day-to-day life. The clothes of Gulliver, which were prepared after his measurement was taken with geometric instruments, proves that prudence along with knowledge is equally important. Thus, Swift satirizes the experimental philosophy of the Royal Society of London during his time. The floating island can also mean the technology-driven world that is concerned with the technical advancement but is not worried about the practical concerns. As the world is moving into the artificially intelligent enabled technology, abstract intelligence is gaining control over human intelligence. The world today, unlike the societies of past, is troubled by the digital divide. The projects being carried out are ridiculed because they don't have human utility. Even if sunbeams are extracted from the cucumber, then also what good would it serve to the human society? The satire also has the political connotations. Laputa governing Baldy Barbie can also mean England controlling Ireland. It also takes into ambit the discussion on differences between pure science and applied science. While applied sciences directly benefit the human society, pure sciences do it in an implicit manner. Thank you.